Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm feeling particularly graphically appealing. Why, do you ask? Because I found an app called Canva, a new web-based graphics app, which is kind of taking the internet by storm, and there's good reason for it. You want to know the reason? I bet you do. Stick around and I'll show you. All right, Canva is an app which is brand new, still got a few bugs to work out as far as some of the interface things goes, but it's got a really pragmatic and practical approach to creating graphics. And they've created it in a wizard type format that makes it easy for you and I to create really appealing looking graphical elements. So they do two things for us. They probably do more than two things, but two things that I'm going to focus on today. First is they give us templates. So they give us structure and they give us ideas and concepts with the templates that allow us to create great elements. And the type of elements, they've broken them down into the things that we actually need to create, like our Facebook cover photo or a poster. So both printing and presentation, both printing and web-based, a social media block, the sort of thing that you might want to be putting up on Instagram, a Twitter header, a business card. So as I say, print as well as web-based. And they've given us all sorts of tools to help us in that process. And I'll show you those tools in a second. The other thing that they've done is they've made it easy for us to incorporate licensed materials into our graphics. In other words, purchasing clip art or photos, stock photos that we can use to dress up our images. Now, in the past, we could always do that. We could go to stock photo services and we could purchase them, but that was a fairly labyrinthian process where we had to set up accounts and all of that sort of stuff. More trouble than it was worth often for us, so we would just avoid it. Within this app, they've taken the concept of in-app purchases, the sorts of things that we've seen become very popular in games. So now as you browse through your options, you'll find ones that you can pay for and ones that you can have for free. Even the ones that you can pay for, you can lay it out, decide how it's going to look before you click the button to purchase it. So you have the ability to decide exactly what it's going to look like and be able to create a finished graphic before you pay for it. And then when you go to download the image, that's when you pay for it. And the prices seem pretty reasonable. It's usually about $1 an element, which is right in the range, probably cheaper than you'd end up paying if you were going to clip services. So let's just dive in, shall we? Enough talking, Steve. Let's build something simple. I'm going to go into the what they call social media, which basically, to me, I'm looking at this thing, and this might be a nice Instagram post or something like that, something that we use for that, but it's a nice square graphic that we're going to use in some form of social media. And here we see the beginning of the process, and they've got these layouts for us, which give us ideas. And if you're graphically challenged, as am I, this gives you a basis to start getting ideas. Now, each of these elements in here are completely editable. We can change the color. We can change the letters. They're all different. They're all done in different elements. Like this one here is actually quite a complex graphic that I brought in. But each of these letters is actually independently editable. We could actually go in and we could click on them and we could change them and edit it if we wanted. So we could do almost anything we wanted with this. We could change the color background, all of those sorts of things. So we can create this sort of a graphic. And we could use this, for example, in this case here, we'll use this as a background and we'll bring in our own photo on top. But before I do that, I want to show you some of the elements. So these are the basic templates. And then in the text area, this is where it gets really exciting to me. Look at all these little text elements that we can add. And of course, we can edit them all. But that creates really some really nice accents to anything that we're creating. This is a well-conceived app. And as I say, you get to start with it completely for free. You can also upload your own images. So I've got all these different images here that I've already uploaded to play with. So this one here, I thought, okay, I'll take this cool picture of the bus that when I was at social media camp, they had this bus. And let's say for some reason I'm trying to create a graphic with this. I'm going to create a graphic with this element. So I size the bus there. I put it down. And you see how I'm able to kind of create a nice simple graphic. Now, it's got all sorts of filters built in, so I could make it dramatic. I can change the colors to being dramatic. Drop this down a little lower, there we go, so we can see Paris as well. I guess the idea is that I'm going to take this bus to Paris or London. I'm not saying it's the most brilliant graphic ever, but I'm just showing you the tools, so stay with me. So we've got all of these different filters that you can apply, and as well as adjusting the brightness and contrast. You don't go in and actually edit the photo itself, but you can do some fairly elaborate editing. I can go in here, I can change the transparency of the photo, I can make it a background, I can kind of faded in, faded out, so we can see the other things in behind. So you've got all of those different capabilities of editing and managing it. And then when you're ready, you can go and you can add any other accent piece that you might want. And I love these graphics for that sort of thing. So maybe it's a stamp. We'll put a stamp in. We'll put it in there. We'll resize it. As I said, you're starting to get that I'm not all that graphically gifted. Let's say 100%. And I'll change the next text to fun. And I'll say road trip. There we go. So that's it. So that's my graphic that I've just created. It sucks, but you get the idea for what you can do with this. Now, let me go in. Actually, let me grab something that we'd have to pay for. Let me change this background image, and let's go in. And in some of them, I notice that they'll actually tell you when you're paying for a graphic or paying for photo. I'll choose a background. And what I'll do is we'll choose a different photo. We'll choose a photo that's probably, yeah, there it is. As you hovered over top, you see that it's something that you would actually end up paying for. So let's say I'm going to add that graphic to the background there. So instead, now we've got that background with that thing. So we've done an awesome looking image. Once you've created it, then you click link and publish. This is where it creates a link to it. But if you decide that you're going to publish it for PDF for printing or to the web, you click on it, and any charges that you have that are going to be attached to this particular graphic are given here. So then we can make our payment. Just you can pay on your credit card right here. And you can also purchase credits at this point here and save a little money. But it tells you all of the elements, which ones you pay for, which ones you don't. Or you can download a watermark draft so you can have somebody approve it before you go and pay for it. So what this does is it, A, gives us some really nice tools for creating compelling graphical elements, especially those of us who are graphically challenged. We don't have to go into dedicated graphic software. We're able to do it all right here within this web interface. Secondly, it gives us an easy conduit to great quality clip art and stock photography that can really add value to any graphics that we are creating. And it makes an easy interface and an easy process for us, making sure that we stay legal, that we're using it in the proper form, and it very clearly defines where we're allowed to use it and where we're not allowed to use it as we go along. Let me show you one other thing. I am doing a webinar coming up with my friend Brooks Duncan. We're doing a paperless office webinar using Evernote as a base. And I wanted to create a new header for my Facebook page. So I chose the Facebook template there, and using the app, I very quickly created this graphic. Now, to be fair, I did export the graphic and I went into Photoshop and dressed up some of the text a little bit to create a cleaner drop shadow and a little bit cleaner text. But I was essentially able to create this graphic using the templates and the ideas from that app, which I was then able to throw up onto my Facebook as a header, which I think looks pretty good. It's certainly doing the job of driving people and informing them that we are having this webinar coming up and getting them to sign up. So this took me maybe 20 minutes total, maybe half an hour total, to create this graphic, which if I was puzzling it out myself just in Photoshop, it would have taken me hours, and it wouldn't have looked this good because I just don't have the graphic eye. I never would have thought of using these elements, the free webinar with and then the other information. I never would have thought of doing those things myself. So overall, Canva is got a huge thumbs up for me. It's a free app to use, in-app purchases. They're early on in their career. Be the first on your block to try it out. I hope you found our video today to be useful, and just a quick reminder that there are three ways that you can become part of the Dotto Tech community if you want to stay in touch with us. First is subscribe to this channel. That way you'll see all of the videos as soon as they are released. Secondly, sign up for our newsletters and you'll get an email once a week with a digest of all of our videos, plus notice of things like this webinar that we have coming up on the paperless office. And finally, this channel is actually supported by the community that watches it through Patreon, which is a crowdfunding site for content creators. So click on our Patreon link, take a look, see if it's something that you might be willing to participate in, and if you are, I certainly appreciate the support. And even if you're not, I appreciate you taking a look and considering supporting us. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.